I also wanted to get your thoughts on another story that's been unfolding this week, the clash between the Senate Intel Committee and the CIA. This has the potential to be a serious constitutional crisis.
We've seen it before, haven't we?
Yeah, and I'm wondering if this is going to lead to a Church Commission or if Feinstein is going to end up backing away. You want to give us the setup on this? The backstory?
Well, I mean, the setup is you had George Bush who unleashed this. The question is, did Obama continue it? Obama's come out and said, no, I don't see any big problem here, which I think is a remarkable statement coming from the White House. But the point is, Bush was trying to figure out what congressmen, what senators were doing about things like torture, about things like war. He wanted to know the backstory to that, and what he would do is he would simply spy on Congress. Well, we saw something similar to this. You just mentioned the church hearings. Well, the church hearings, congressmen and senators learned the same thing. Not only was government spying on them, government was spying on journalists, they were spying on newspaper people, they were spying on activists, they were spying on union members, and more importantly, they were spying on political opponents. J. Edgar Hoover was the master of this. Dick Nixon thought it was a wonderful idea, and he took it up to a whole new level until there were hearings that said, you know what, we have to take a look at how bad this is. This could lead to another church-type hearing, but I think the irony is Dianne Feinstein, this is a woman who day after day says, oh, you know, there's nothing wrong with spying, there's nothing wrong with the telecommunications companies figuring out what you're talking about on the telephone, what you're using with your computer, what you're using on your iPad, or your telephone. There's no problem with that. But when she's caught, when she figures out that they might have been spying on Dianne Feinstein, then that double standard kicks in. And I think that double standard has potential to have legs.
Yeah. It seems to me like she might be having an epiphany, you know, a Paul of Tarsus on the road moment where her eyes have been awakened. Do you think it's going to stick, or do you think that this was just she strikes me as the kind of person who doesn't pull a Sarah Palin, doesn't just, you know, say something because it flitted through her mind today or because it's been on her mind for the last couple of days and she's upset about it. This has been going on for a couple of years, apparently, without a word from her. And finally, she reached a breaking point.
What it tells you, Thom, is first of all, I begin with the position that Feinstein was somebody who was just perfectly fine with pushing the absolute limits on privacy for everybody else. And it leads me to believe that she knows a lot more than the media is talking about. Now, this is the kind of story that disappears if you have a president of the United States saying, this is no big deal. Now, why did he say that? Why is it that you have Obama saying, you know, this really isn't a problem? He's saying it because that becomes the talking point for all Democrats. And if Democrats do that, we're never going to get to that Frank Church kind of hearing moment that we need so desperately. We're never going to figure out that it's not just the military that's spying on activists and news people and congressmen and political opponents. It's not just the military. It's the contractors who work for the military. It's the private contractors that are making far more money on this than anybody. It's a whole new industry. Thom, if you walk around the Beltway right now, if you just look around the Beltway, look at the articles that talk about that's where all the wealth is. You know why? Because that's where all the military contractors have gone. And about a half of those military contractors are involved with gathering information. And so that's where this should lead. What's happening in their backyard? Well, it's not just the other people being spied on now. It's Dianne Feinstein.
Yeah. Well, isn't this a way emblematic of how this privatization, you know, the military contractors, has just run amok?
Well, it's run amok because what lobbyists have done is convinced legislators that they can do it better. And what they haven't, the rest of the story that legislators don't seem to be able to get through their thick head is this is not something that they simply use for the benefit of the military. There's story after story that's coming to the surface now where you have private contractors that are taking the very information that they're selling to the military and selling it to other private industries. Items that should on any terms be completely private. but this is where this is headed. It is a new industry, and it's lucrative.
Yeah. Mike Papantonio, thanks so much for being with us tonight, Pap.